Hello, I'm Saukki, and I think that now it's a good time to review my Quattrovelo. I have been riding with this for about, well, more than 5,000 kilometers in various conditions, so I think that now I can form some kind of opinion about this. So, let's start! Okay, so this is the Voyager. You gave the name, by the way. My Quattrovelo number 233 from 2020. And this is made by Velomobile.nl. It comes with full carbon body and four wheels, while most other models are three-wheelers. But I, of course, got some optional accessories, like the more powerful Aigu X headlights, more about those later, this head-in-hood, which is very good in this kind of climate. By the way, people call this head-in-hood the alien hood, because, well, it kind of looks like the alien from the movie. Then I got the child seat, so I can take my kid with me, and he can see out from there through the side windows. His legs are hanging here, both sides of the front seat. Then I got the mountain drive, which is pretty useless in my area because it's so flat. Except that in winter, this is a lifesaver. I really need this in winter. Hey, by the way, if you want to know how well the Quattrovelo handles the Nordic winter, check out my winter review video, which I made earlier. The link is now in the top corner of the video, or also in the video description. Then I got the larger 90mm brakes, because I thought that with the kid at the back seat, I might need the extra stopping power. And then I also got this lift handle and few other things. So far the only major problem I had with this was one of the rear dampers which broke after a few hundred kilometers. But I got a new part from Velomobile.nl as a warranty replacement. Other than that, I've had no other issues. I've commuted with the Voyager the whole spring and summer with no issues, and I've also made few successful long rides. So far this seems to be a pretty reliable machine. Now let's list some pros and cons. Let's start with the most obvious. Because this is a four-wheeler, this is very stable, and I can ride every corner with great confidence. And because of the stability, it's also possible to use this throughout the harsh winter we have here. Quattrovelo has very good lights. The standard headlights are okay, because they are positioned up and away from each other. But by upgrading the standard lights to these Aigu X headlights, makes this setup excellent. You can see very well where you are going. The only problem with these powerful headlights is that the battery life is relatively short. It lasts only few hours when on full beam. That's why I mostly use the daytime running lights mode, then the battery life is reasonable. But anyway, back to the excellent lights. Tail lights are very good as well. There's three LEDs, like this, positioned far away from each other, so it makes the Velomobile to appear larger in darkness. Then there's of course brake lights, which you can actually turn permanently on as a fog light. Very clever. Turning signal LEDs are also positioned far away from the center line of the Velomobile, so it's more easier for the drivers behind to see and understand my turning signals. Then this has very good luggage space. I guess this is one of the most spacious Velomobiles out there. I can easily fit two pack of groceries and a kid to the back of the Quattrovelo. So yes, you can have a child seat as well. I think if you spend little bit more time to pack all the stuff efficiently, you could fit maybe one more pack of groceries inside. But then if you don't have the child seat, then there will be room for probably one or maybe even two more bags. So there really is a lot of room. Then this Quattrovelo has very comfortable suspension and good enough ground clearance. So the ride is comfortable and you don't have to worry about all the speed bumps. I think the Quattrovelo ground clearance is better than a Quest, even though it might not look like it at the first glance. Quest has this chain tunnel, which makes the ground clearance pretty small, but Quattro has flat bottom, except that the versions with Rohloff gearbox has additional chain tunnel underneath. The seat adjustment is pretty easy. There's basically just these straps which you have to adjust. But I've heard that the front mount of the Seat is a known failure point of older Quattrovelos. But at least mine has some reinforcement around the mounting hole. I hope this is the case with all new Quattrovelos nowadays. Then of course, like most other Velomobiles, the drivetrain is inside the Velomobile, so all the dirt and mud stays outside. In my opinion, this is one of the best features of a Velomobile. And talking about drivetrain, both of the Quattrovelo rear wheels are driven. This doesn't have traditional differential, instead this has two freewheel system, and that means that in slippery conditions, the wheel which is not slipping is driven. So this has excellent traction, for example on snow.
I do have to say that I kind of like the shape of the Quattrovelo, especially from this angle. I like the curvy shape around the rear wheels, like here. But I'm not so sure if I'm a big fan of the cat face at the rear or the owl face at the front. But other than that, this looks very beautiful and curvy.
Then what I also like about the Quattrovelo and other Velomobiles made by Velomobile.nl is the attention to details. For example, there's this clever place for handlebar where you can put it while climbing in so that it's out of the way. There's additional luggage compartments at the front, although it might be difficult to access. There are these USB ports so you can charge your phone while riding, and then you can adjust the headlights very easily so you don't blind other drivers. Then there's the speed. Luckily this is just tiny bit slower or more inefficient than a Quest on a straight road. But with Quattrovelo you can ride the corners much faster, like for example roundabouts. With Quattro I can ride almost full speed, while with Quest I had to slow down to stay upright. So actually in some cases the Quattrovelo might be as fast or even faster than a Quest. But for me, the slower speed is a con. Other cons are already mentioned battery life when running the more powerful IQX headlights with the full beam, and the seat front mount failing in some older Quattrovelos. Then the maintenance seems more difficult compared to a Quest, but so far the only maintenance I've done is to lubricate the chain, and that already seems more difficult because there's not very good access to the chain. There's fairly good access to the rear derailleur, but the access hatch is located at the bottom, which might be somewhat cumbersome. Then, well, now I'm a little bit stretching it trying to find something to complain when there's not much to complain. But the build quality wasn't so good this time. For example, the paint quality isn't as high standard as my Quest was. And then this came with scratch already mounted. Then the manhole cover is not symmetrical. Not a big problem, but it sometimes annoys me because the other side of the manhole cover is touching to my earbud. Then some more complaints about the manhole cover. I've learned how to live with the head in hood plus manhole cover compilation, which I was complaining about in my winter review. So it's not a problem for me anymore. Until you add a mini visor, then it gets super annoying again. In summer I mostly ride with the manhole open and mini visor on, but if it starts to rain, then I have to use the manhole cover as well. And by the way, there isn't as good place to store the manhole cover inside the Velomobile as there was in a Quest. In a Quest you could put the manhole cover under the front part of the body, but that's not possible in a Quattrovelo. The best place to store it here is just to throw it back to the luggage space. But if you have some luggage with you, then the next best place is behind the seat, like that. But if you have the child seat and a kid sitting on it and some luggage at the rear, then where you can store the manhole cover? Well, it turns out that there's still room for the manhole cover behind the seat. It's just quite difficult to get over there and back again, because the child seat gets in the way. But you can get everything to fit. It just gets a little bit on the way of my elbows. I want to have the cover with me so I can close the manhole while visiting in store or something. But if it's a hot summer day, I don't want to ride with the manhole cover on. Then one more thing to complain. There's not enough drainage holes. If there's a liquid dripping somewhere inside, it has no way out. There is hole for the chain tunnel inside the Velomobile, but there's no other holes. But on the other hand, that's an easy fix.
Hey, by the way, I do like this type of visor. This is this kind of motorbike helmet type of visor. And this is much better, in my opinion, than the Lexan visor that I had with my Quest. then you can also mount the pin lock inserts, those reduce fogging. But okay, I think it's time to give some kind of rating for my Quattrovelo. So this seems to be a very reliable and stable machine in almost any kind of conditions. And the most important things to me are that I can use this around the year, even in our harsh winter that we have here. And then that I can take my kid with me, because there's the child seat. Also the luggage space is pretty huge and the lights are excellent. And that's actually pretty important, because it gets pretty dark soon, because, well, winter is coming. But even though this is very good machine, it's not perfect. There are a few small complaints that I mentioned earlier, so I can't quite give this 5 out of 5 stars. This would be solid 4.5 out of 5 stars, but there's just one thing that I just can't get over with, and it's the speed. So someone else might give this a higher rating than I am, because I'm giving this only 4 out of 5 stars, and that's only because this is little bit slower than a Quest. But okay, I think that's all for today. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you find this very interesting. Please remember to subscribe if you haven't done it already. Just click the subscription button below the video. And then also visit my webshop and buy something like this kind of awesome t-shirts or something else. But anyway, thanks for watching this video and see you next time. Bye bye.